Yeah, listen, this was a roll of the dice. It is a risk. A story like this can go wrong six ways to Sunday. And Tom McCarthy and co-writer Josh Singer, they were under no obligation whatsoever to involve us in the process. So we're just lucky that our story landed in the hands of such talented filmmakers and such incredibly talented and committed actors. Well, I did have a moment like that when I was doing the research into Father John Gagan, who was the priest with whom we opened the series, after I learned that Father Gagan had molested more than 150 children in six different parishes over 30 years with the knowledge of his superiors in the Boston Archdiocese. I looked up his assignment at his very last parish. After 30 years of molesting children, and I found that his last assignment was to be in charge of the altar boys. And that, I felt, was just so depraved. I couldn't understand how that could possibly happen. And it really was at that moment when I told myself, this is going to be a really big story. Well, there is another side of this, however, which is the internet has also provided us with a lot of tools to practice investigative reporting. And it's given rise to some interesting models for investigative reporting. I think there are several online-only investigative reporting organizations that are doing really, really high-quality work. And I think we're in a period of transition here, and there are many things about it that are troubling. There are several things about it that are hopeful. And I just think that investigative reporting is so essential to democracy that we're going to get through this, and we're going to find a model that works, and investigative reporting will survive and thrive, and seriously, God help us if it doesn't. Well, I'm a fan of the movies, and I'd followed Mark's career just out of general interest, and I was a great admirer of his, so you know, I was thrilled to death when I heard that Mark was going to play me in the movie. Now, when he came to my house and opened up his notebook and turned on his iPhone and started taking pictures and asking me personal questions, I began to wonder just exactly how this was going to go. But I sort of slapped myself around metaphorically, and I told myself, hey, pal, you do this to people all the time, so relax.
I just picture you in the bathroom having that conversation.
and him listening.
And after that, it really went fantastically well, and I developed even more respect for Mark than I already had. He worked very, very hard and put his entire heart and soul into this project, and the results you see, which is to say he succeeded brilliantly. So I was, so to speak, loath to have any of my personal life in the movie, but the great reporters here and the filmmaking crew and the cast did manage to get some in, and what you see in the film is very accurate. I mean, I was a lapsed Catholic at the time, but I identified as a Catholic. We have a writer in Boston, in the Boston Globe, who's a former priest, James Carroll, who writes about Catholic issues, and I always sort of considered myself a James Carroll Catholic. But quite honestly, after reporting the story and encountering the lies of so many high Catholic officials, that I think the break at this point is irreparable. I don't really identify as a Catholic now.